We good?
It was awesome.
I did that for the first time in like years.
This year's 32nd annual drag show was themed Smoke and Mirrors, the Magic of Drag. We had the pleasure of covering the show and interviewing some of the performers, so come take a look into the behind-the-scenes moments and clips of performances as we venture into the art of all things drag.
My name is Asia, and my pronouns are they, them. My drag name is Harper Fixation.
My name is Mix. I use they and she. I'm a trans femme non-binary whitey.
My name is Juicy Dilemma, and I use it or any pronouns.
I'm Silver Screen, I use he, him.
My drag name is Belladonna. My pronouns are anything. Mostly they, them, but I'm not, like, I like she, her, he, him, it's all of the things.
Drag to me means being my most powerful self, the most authentic self, being able to connect with the audience in just this really intimate way. And then also queering the meaning of like pop songs and making my own meaning from it.
Big and a little bit caricature-y. I always like more campy drag, but it is sort of different for every person. For some people it's expressing their true inner femininity or masculinity or androgyny or whatnot. So it really depends on the person, but for me, it's just, what do I want to do today?
Drag to me means freedom of expression, freedom of gender. It means pissing off right-wing people. It means having a fucking good time and throwing a fucking party, baby.
Drag means an expression of gender, which is kind of what is usually said about drag, but like to me it's kind of an exploration of that through that, which I think is common with a lot of performers, but I think it's a very like versatile art form, which I think is very I love that about an art form. I like, because I like the need to be doing 100 different things at once, and I think drag fulfills all of that.
Drag is a way to like kind of like isolate a certain part of yourself that you wouldn't be able to like otherwise express, and then put it under a like magnifying glass. So just kind of like giving yourself the opportunity to be like that big like extra personified like version of yourself that usually doesn't get to come to light. That's kind of what it means to me.
I think what makes my drag magical is the fact that it just comes from my own silly little brain, and I'm able to like take this dream or this daydream that I have and make it into a reality.
I have, more often than not, a lot of people after I do a ballad come up to me and say that I was like making them cry or they were about to cry, and that for me is like a really good sign because that means I'm doing my job really well. So I think that I'm very magical in the way that I can like manipulate your emotions, you know what I mean?
Well, it's always pretty campy. I love to start out with weird stuff like this, and then take it off, and then be something else, and then that's it. And I love doing that. I love throwing things. Sometimes I'll have things in my pockets and throw them, and that's always really fun.
My drag's magical because I'm a huge fucking nerd. Because I'm a big fan of the movies, hence my name, which I did change my name, which I'll get on that, but I like to wear all my influences on my sleeve. Like this is, it's hard to tell because I have the process going on in my head. I don't know if it translates to this, but I'm a huge fan of Tetsuo the Iron Man. And I know like in my performances, I like to mix in little clips from like movies I love. And I love to like explore like my own gender through, say, like Tetsuo the Iron Man. I love a lot of like like 80s new wave bands. So I think that general like exploration of like myself through how other people have expressed their art, I think drag is the perfect outlet for that.
I like to play with the gender a lot. I think that being like a cunty man whore or like a they them whore is like very much like my thing. I like becoming like a living piece of art. So I get really into like the makeup and the wigs and just like overall like creating a cohesive piece of not just like, you know, a costume, but like actual art. That's kind of how I like to look at it.
What inspired you to do the outfit that you're wearing tonight?
I don't know. This is kind of like this is a recreation of like one of my first ever drag looks. So I thought it would be like at least meaningful to me personally to kind of bring them back to life, because like the first time I did this look, it was like, I don't know, it was like at like the Ridgewick Carnival, and I was like, I don't know what I'm doing, and now I kind of know what I'm doing, just a little bit more. So I felt like it was gonna be a good opportunity to kind of like bring the Belladonna persona back to life in a new context and light.
What got me into drag was going to Rumors. I like to watch the performers and just see what they're up to. They always have something new and creative. But then being in a drag club here at Western was really wonderful, because that's like a space that isn't just 21 and over. And then something that surprised me about drag was I wasn't prepared for the way that it was going to feel from the other side, because I'm used to just being an audience member. But it is, like, I do feel a lot of support from the audience, and that's wonderful. That's a great feeling.
There's so many new performers coming up, and they are constantly creating new ideas, and I see their creativity and all of their brilliant ideas, and it makes me see things in a new way, and so it pushes me to be a better artist and just wanting to do more, and I don't ever want to be overshadowed by them.
Since it's not been that long, I haven't seen that much of like a shift or a real like mold yet. I think it takes some time to really feel the effects of anything like that. But from what I've seen so far, depending on the setting, it sort of just repeats itself. Like history. For example, I started performing with the drag club here at Western because I wasn't 21 yet. And that is not anywhere near the same or even similar, in my opinion, to performing in bars and stuff, which I just started doing semi-recently.
Well, I changed my name to Silver Screen because I started feeling like when I started drag, I didn't really know who I wanted to be, and I was kind of afraid to fit in, and I knew what a drag king was, but I didn't exactly know where to fit myself into that term and where to fit myself in as an artist. But I feel like as my drag's evolved, I've come to like learn like where to put myself within my drag, and I feel like I've learned, just... Like, my name's changed. I recognize more things within myself than I did before, and I actually know how to choreograph now.
I don't know, because, like, when I first started, I, like, wasn't really sure, like, what to do, because I started out as a cosplayer. And then I was like, okay, I know how to do the makeup, but I don't know how to do anything else. Like, I was like, I'm not you know, great at performing yet and like all that kind of stuff. So I feel like as I've like entered the community, I've like met so many people that have shown me like what performing and stuff looks like. So I've been able to evolve in that way, as well as like developing sort of like my makeup skills in the drag context opposed to like the cosplay context. And just like, I don't know, just meeting so many cool people, like kind of fangirling back there because there's so many like people I look up to and respect. And I feel like that's a huge part of like growing as an artist yourself, is being around people that inspire you. So
what are your names?
I'm Dizzyphoria.
Oh, this is a video. I'm Issa.
All right, and then how are y'all feeling right now?
So good, yes, can't wait. Yes.
First-time drag performer, are you?
Oh, baby, never. This good on their first time? Never. But they think they do. They think they do. Keep this in. This is the B-roll.
Yes.